Hi everyone, we are going to finish the project for in class number 7 together. To do that everyone, if you will do a file open and find the assets for our class. Let me get this from this file. In your DGM assets folder, in your in class assignments, under Photoshop, there's an in-class 7 folder. If you will open up fruit as well as butterfly, you can select two documents by holding onto your control key and go ahead and click open. In order to do this assignment, I'm going to zoom in so you can see what it is we'll be doing to this. We are going to take this scratch out of this document. We're also going to make this so it's not quite so green just by doing a few things here. If you go up here to Image Adjustments and go to the word Levels, you can also do a Control L. There's a function here called Auto. If you click Auto, it will automatically go in there and Photoshop will use its input levels and output levels that it recommends for this image to make it look a little bit better. Most of the time as a photographer, it's good to be able to do that. You can also change the levels yourself by just sliding these input levels to what your likeness would be. You can also change the output levels that increases and decreases the light. Go ahead and click OK. Then we're going to take the scratch out. Make sure that you unlock your background. I'm just going to put here the fruit bowl. And then we're going to grab our lasso tool. And carefully with your lasso tool, if you will just go around the scratch that you see. It works well if you have a thumbprint or if there's something that when the image possibly was scanned in, there's errors on it. There's a very quick way to actually fix this. Then you go up and you click Filter. And if you go into the filter to find dust and scratches, it's a filter under noise. If you choose dust and scratches, the way to improve the scratch is to actually increase the radius just 1 or 2 pixels and it will totally remove the scratch. It's a quick way to be able to edit it. I recognize here that because I had to remove the scratch through the leaf of the celery, that I can actually go in here and edit that. I'm going to do a Control D to get rid of my selection and get out of the filter. If I want to put this leaf back in, I'm going to use what's called my Clone Tool. Clone Tool is measured in brush sizes. And with your clone tool, I can just take a picture to replace this leaf right here of a leaf that's kind of right, maybe right here or right here that I can plug in here. So I'm going to hold on to my Alt key. I get a navigator window and I'm going to let go and click with my left mouse. I just took a picture of it and then I'm just going to kind of fill in a little bit of that celery. Just so it doesn't look so blurred, I'm not looking for perfection, your first introduction to the clone tool. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to use what's called the quick select. Make sure that you share that with the magic wand. I'm also going to click here where it says add selection. There's a little plus up here on the menu that allows me to quick select multiple times using my left mouse. I'm also going to look out here and I'm going to quick select this tomato, but I got a fairly large brush size, so I would get a pretty small brush size. And then you go over here and with your quick select key, you just click. It will quickly grab your tomato. If you notice on this tomato, this one's very, very light and pink. The rest of them are red, and what we want to do is just brighten this tomato. The way that you do that is you add a new adjustment layer. So if you go up here to the layer palette and you click new adjustment layer and you go into brightness. Here it's asking you, hey, what do you want to call the new layer? We're going to call this tomato. Then we'll know this is the part of the image that we create, that we edited. It looks very similar to a mask because we've just outlined only the tomato. And the only thing we want to do is just lower the brightness on the tomato so that it matches the red of the other tomatoes. It may require us to just lose a little bit of the contrast to blend it in as well. That's how quickly it is, how easy it is to use the new adjustment layer. We're also going to make an adjustment layer for the table runner. Once again, we're going to use our quick select and we're going to click all the parts of the white. Now notice my brush is fairly big when I do quick select. So I'm going to go down here and reduce the size of my brush to a smaller so I can get exactly what I want just by hitting the white. That's the only thing that I want to select is the white area. So I've reduced my brush size to a fairly small size so I can get this all selected. Then what I'd like to do is change the color of my table run. To do that, I'll go up here to Layer, New Adjustment Layer. This time we're going to choose Hue and Saturation. We're going to say that we're going to change the color of the table runner. So that's the new layer that will look like a mask. This tells me that I'm actually choosing Hue and Saturation, this icon. Then we're going to go over here and click the Colorize button. And whatever hue you're on, that should be the color of the tablecloth. You may choose any color that you'd like. Just adjust it from being white. You may also increase or decrease the saturation depending on how much opacity of color you'd like in there, as well as the lightness. All right. Then I have a butterfly that you're going to add to the mix. So if you'll drag down your butterfly, we're going to add this to this assignment. And we just want to isolate the butterfly by itself. So we'll go up here and change to the magic wand. We'll go ahead and click on the white space because the magic wand will select all of the white. Then we'll choose select the inverse. We now have the butterfly isolated by itself. I'll quickly move the butterfly and drop it onto my fruit bowl. When this layer comes in, it identifies it as layer one. Please call it butterfly. And then with this butterfly, if you'll resize it, if your show transform controls aren't there, please click here so that you can see the show transform controls because you're on the move command. And if you'll just make a smaller butterfly. What I'd like to see is 5 different butterflies floating or flying around this fruit bowl. So then what I would do is duplicate the layer. And I would type in butterfly 2. Go ahead and click OK. And now I've got a second butterfly. And you can just adjust them so you have a few of them flying around, all different sizes on the fruit bowl. Please have 5 butterflies. I'll let you go ahead and do that by yourself. I'm going to go ahead and do a file save as. And the name of this document will be, and you'll put it inside your Photoshop completed folder, the name of this one will be in class 7 underscore your first name underscore your last name. Go ahead and hit save. Then you'll also save it as a JPEG, so you'll do a file save as, change the type from a PSD to the JPEG format. And then go ahead and hit save. You've now completed in class number 7 and you can upload that to Canvas. Please upload the JPEG first and then the PSD.